So let us continue, students. Okay. So this table, students, it is see orbital distribution in the first four shell K L M N. And as I told, N onwards it is going to be same. Okay, N onwards it is going to be same. So the understanding the first four is very much important. So you all can see here they have written principal quantum number. Then they have written azimuthal quantum number. Yes or no? They have also written values for ML. And in order to find how many values are there in ML, we use this formula, right? 2L plus 1. So for all the, for the first four shells, they have done all these calculations for you all to understand that how to do the calculations. Okay, fine. Yes or no? So if I give you all, for example, if I tell you all that write down the principal azimuth and orbital quantum number for M shell. Okay. So you all should know like how to write it for M shell. First, you all will write what N is. Then you all will write the value for L. Okay. So you all can see over here. See, for M, N is 3. L is what? L is 2 actually. So 2 means because M has SPD, right? So SPD. So value of S is 0, D is 1. P is 1 and D is 2. So you all have to write that 0, 1, 2. Okay, fine. I hope you all are understanding this. Then you all have to use 2L plus 1. Okay. And then students, see over here, please be careful. You all have to write the range for ML for every subshell. Okay. ML is determining the orbitals inside subshell. So if any shell has 3 subshells in it, so you all have to write the range for ML for all 3. Okay, fine. Students, do one thing that after the lecture gets over, go through all the topics that I just discussed again. Go through this table carefully. You all will understand what is happening. Okay. Because I already explained everything. Now comes the important part, that is how to write electronic configuration. So this table is the, you know, symbol of subshell. So what I'll do is I'll directly explain that when we get to configuration. Before that, there is one small thing that you all should know is shapes of the subshell. Okay. Like what is the shape? So students, your S subshell is a spherical in shape. Now obviously in 2D you cannot show it. So that is why they have just drawn a circle, but it is actually a sphere. Okay, fine. If we go ahead, like the next subshell that is there. Okay. So you all can see here, this is S. Then what is P? Just a minute. Okay. Your P, inside P, there are 3 orbitals, right? Now one orbital, it has this infinity kind of shape, or it is dumbbell shaped in nature. Okay, fine. Now students, what are the 3 orbitals inside P? They are labeled as PX, PY, PZ. Okay. So you all can see this diagram. As if for now, don't worry about what this 2 is. I'll explain that. As if for now, just concentrate on PX, PY, PZ. Okay, fine. So students, your P subshell has dumbbell shape. Okay. And we know that P subshell has 3 orbitals inside it. So basically all the 3 orbitals have dumbbell shape. Now what makes them different? Obviously the labeling is different, but on what basis I have written PX, PY, PZ? So you all can see here along the, I hope you all know we have 3 axes. Okay. X, Y, Z. So you all can see for PX, the dumbbell shape is oriented along the X axis. Okay. You all can see it is along the X axis. In PY, the dumbbell shape is along the Y axis, and in PZ, it is along the Z axis. Okay. Fine. See students, it is like this actually. Alright, so normally we label this as X, Y and Z. Okay, you all can use this labeling in your textbook. What they have done is, in your textbook, they have labeled this section as X, this section as Y and this as Z. So that is up to you all. Okay, you all can use any labeling and just draw a dumbbell on top of it, or draw an infinity shape on top of it. Alright, fine. So these are the 3 orbitals of your P. Okay, next if I talk about D, you all remember D has 5 orbitals, yes or no? So what are the 5 orbitals of D? DXY, it is very small. Wait, I'll just zoom it in. Okay, I think so. Now it's a little bit clear. All right, so the first one is DXY, second is DXZ, then DYZ. So basically, all the 3 axes, 2-2 combinations. First X and Y, then Y and Z, and then X and Z. Okay, fine. Then the fourth one is dx square minus y square. And the fifth one is dz square. Okay, fine. And these are the respective shapes of the orbital. So these are the 5 orbitals inside D subshell. And these are their shapes. Now I know students, the ones for D is a little bit complicated as compared to P. The one in P was very simple. Like dumbbell, one infinity along Px. along py along pz. Here we are supposed to include two parts. So you all can see in xy, okay, in xy there is one along x-axis and one along y-axis. Just concentrate on the labels where they have labeled xyz. Okay, fine. In xz, there is one along x-axis and one along z-axis. So it is like that. Okay, the orientation is like that. Okay, fine. Next for P students, okay. All right, one thing. Shapes are not important for writing electronic configuration. Okay, you all are just supposed to remember these names. Like what are the names of the orbitals? Okay, so shapes are actually not important for writing electronic configuration. So let's not get into that detail. Anyways, this will be covered when the chapter is taught to y'all completely from start to end. And for F, now students, for F we have 7 orbitals. So it means that the structures are going to be even more complex. So they prefer not teaching y'all shapes of F. And even their names are not given anywhere. Okay, so they are only given for S, P and D. Okay, fine. So this was a little bit about shapes and everything. All right, fine. I think so now we can start the main configuration part. Okay, fine. All right. Now, before I get to that, here this one more topic. Just a minute, okay? There is one more topic that we need to discuss. So please see to it that y'all are on page number. What page number this is? You're on page number 49 of your textbook with pencils in your hand. All right, fine. Okay. Now, see, students, we all know that how we write electronic configuration based on atomic number. Yes or no? Now, if the atomic number is higher, it obviously means that particular element has more shells involved in it. Okay, fine. Like if I'm talking about just simply hydrogen atom, simply hydrogen has only the first one, the K shell in it. Okay, fine. Yes or no? But if I move ahead, the shell number increases, right? Like L gets involved, then M gets involved, then N. And if you all will go to the end parts of the table, of the periodic table with very high atomic numbers, more and more shells are involved into picture. Okay, fine. Now, students, in this scenario, it becomes very much important to determine the energy of these shells. Okay. I think so. I should explain to you all now this column so that you all understand what I'm talking about. Okay, fine. Now, see, students, as I said, in this electronic configuration, we are going to give the exact position of the electron. Okay, fine. What we can do is, I can just take one compound directly. Just a minute. Okay, it's here. Your periodic table is here, right? Okay, fine. Okay, what we can do is, I think so we can take sodium, all right? Okay, now you all tell me, according to the normal configuration that you all used to write before, okay, sodium, that is 11, okay? How you all used to write the configuration for sodium? What is the bifurcation that we'll have?
281,
okay, what about others? This is how you all used to write, right? Yes or no?
Yes, miss.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. All right. 281. Now, students, sodium around the nucleus, we have first shell, that is K. We know that inside K shell, only S subshell is present. So it means that my K shell can occupy only 2 electrons. This is something that you all already know. So out of the 11 electrons, okay, the first 2 electrons, okay, out of the 11 electrons of sodium, the first 2 electrons will go inside the first shell, okay? And inside the first shell, which subshell? S subshell. How many electrons? 2 electrons, okay? You all are understanding. 1s2, like before, how you all used to write just 2? Yes or no? Now you all are not supposed to write just 2. You all are supposed to indicate which shell, which subshell, how many electrons. So the first 2 electrons have gone into the first shell. Inside the first shell, I have S subshell and the 2 electrons. This 2 is indicating 2 electrons have gone inside the S subshell. Okay. So out of 11, 2 electrons are gone. So now we are left with 9 electrons. Yes or no? So now we know that in first shell, only S subshell is there. So now we have to move to the second shell. Now students, in the second shell, how many subshells are there? 2, right? S and P. So firstly, what will happen in the second shell? s inside the s subshell of the second shell, two more electrons will enter. So out of the 11 now, out of the 11 electrons, four electrons have been placed. Okay, now I'm left with seven electrons. All right. What comes after s? Since we are in the second shell p is also there, right? So I will write 2p. Okay. Now students, what is the capacity of electrons? How many electrons p subshell can hold? Anyone?
Three.
How many electrons, not how many orbitals? This is a very tricky question. P has three orbitals, but how many total electrons P subshell?
Six.
Because every orbital will have two electrons, right? So 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 electrons. Yes or no? So P can hold maximum. See, S can hold maximum only 2 electrons. That is why I can fill only 2 electrons over here. But P can hold 6 electrons, right? So I will write 6 over here. Now, students, tell me how many electrons are left, like out of the 11. How many electrons are left now?
One.
Now, can you all tell me where will this one go? Now, see, first shell has S subshell, that is done. Second shell has S and P, that is also completely filled. Completely filled means it has reached its capacity. Now, S ka capacity is 2, wo ho gaya. P ka capacity is 6, wo bhi full ho gaya. फिर भी हमारा एक इलेक्ट्रॉन बचा है, तो वो एक इलेक्ट्रॉन कहाँ जाएगा अभी?
डी.
नो, थिंक केयरफुली.
3s1.
3s1, वेरी गुड, एक्सीलेंट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, डी अभी तक आया ही नहीं है पिक्चर में, है ना? फर्स्ट शेल में खाली एस होता है, सेकेंड शेल में एस और पी होता है, यस और नो? थर्ड शेल में वी हैव एस पी डी. So D has not yet come into picture. 2 does not have D in it. So D mein kaise jayega? So next abhi wo kis mein enter karega? Third shell mein. Third shell mein sabse pehle wo kaha jayega? S mein jayega. But only one electron is there, right? See, maximum capacity of S is 2. But I have only one electron with me. So I will write 3S1. And this is how y'all are supposed to write configuration of sodium. Not 2, 8, 1. Stop doing that. This is how y'all are supposed to write electronic configuration from now onwards. Students, please let me know if y'all understood this.
Yes, miss.
Okay. Do one thing, everyone in your notebooks. Okay, everyone in your notebooks, quickly try how to write configuration for. Oh no, wait, before that I have to explain you all the topic. No, wait, just a minute. What you all can do is, you all can try writing configuration for oxygen. You all can see oxygen, atomic number 8. Okay, write the configuration for oxygen in this manner and tell me what the configuration is. Okay, atomic number is 8. So how I explained for sodium just now, similarly try for oxygen and tell me what the configuration is. Yes, anyone? You should not take that much time. Only very small atomic number, 8. Achha, y'all are sending through chat. Arre baapre. Okay, Hetvi has sent the answer. Correct. Hetvi's answer is correct. What about others? Okay, Angi has sent it. Arre, y'all unmute and say, you know, why y'all are typing so much? Usse achha, y'all can just speak, right? Okay, fine. Okay, everyone almost correct answer. Just a minute, wait. Okay, so people who are sending the answer is correct. Hold on, students, 1 minute. Okay, so students, for 8, now for people who are not able to follow up, please understand, number is 8, right? Atomic number is 8. So first two electrons will go where? Inside the first shell, inside the S subshell. Okay, fine. So we are done with the first shell. Now we will introduce the second shell. So the other two electrons will go into the S part of the second shell. Okay, fine. So till here we are done with four electrons. Now students, in the second shell, we also have P subshell, right? Now, what is the capacity of P? 6. It can hold up to 6 electrons. But I am left with only 4 electrons. So that is not a problem. You all are supposed to write 4 over here. So this is the configuration for oxygen students. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Please let me know if everyone has understood this.
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. Now, this we discussed about compounds having lower atomic numbers. This is not that simple, students. Okay, don't be happy that we are just simply supposed to write sp, then spd, spdf, spdf. Aisa nahi hai. Thoda sa complications hai yahan par. We'll see what those complications are. Just a minute, okay? Okay, let's get back over here. Okay, now I think so. Now you all will be able to understand in this table what is this symbol of subshell, what does it mean, okay? So, jaise ki humne bola hai, ek minute. K has, okay, so 1s means K has only one subshell, right? So, this 1s stands for K, okay? They have not written the number of electrons because that you all will fill accordingly, right? And in L, we have S and P. And L is what? Second shell. So, it is 2s and 2p. M is the third shell which has SPD. So we will have 3S, 3P, 3D. Okay, fine. I think so. Now you all are understanding what this table means. Okay. And last one in N, students, we have 4 subshells, right? So number 4, see students, that 1, 2, 3, 4, it is the principal quantum number. The 1, 2, 3, 4, the shell number that we are writing, it is principal quantum number, right? Yes or no? Now based on... Yes, student, please keep yourselves mute. Only if you all have any doubt, then unmute yourselves. Okay, fine. So that numbers are the principal quantum number. Now, based on principal quantum number, if I just give you principal quantum number, like if I tell you n is equal to 2, so you all will understand. N is 2 means we are talking about L shell. Okay. Hey, and inside L, we have S and P. Just a minute. Okay, inside L, we have S and P. So basically, we have 2S and 2P. Okay, fine. Students, please let me know if now you all are understanding what this table means, what this column means in this table.
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Please pay attention. Don't talk here and there with your family members. Okay, fine. Just a minute. Okay. So what is this? Right. Okay, fine. Okay, so let's move ahead. Just a minute. Okay, now, as I was mentioning one point, that for higher compounds, that is compounds with more atomic number, the configuration is going to be more complex. Now, students, your every orbital, okay, or your every subshell has its own energy level. Okay, fine. So when electron is, for example, if the electron jumps from one shell to another or something like that happens, there is loss or gain of energy. Why this happens, students? Because all the orbitals, or I can say all the subshells, they are at different energy levels. Okay, fine. Like for example, if it jumps from a lower energy level to a higher energy level, okay, it gains energy, the electron. If it jumps from a higher level to a lower level, it releases energy. Okay, this is like basic mechanism, we can say. That is not there over here, but the important point to remember is that every subshell has different energy levels in it. So while you all are writing the configuration, you all have to see to it that you all write it according to the order of energy levels. Dekho students, abhi jo maine do examples diya, oxygen and sodium. So that was not a problem because at the beginning, if you all can see this part over here, okay, this part has been summarized in this diagram also, okay. So you all can see first comes 1s, okay, fine, all right. It's like we go from less to more, all right, less to more. So first comes 1s, or what we can do is, you all can just directly, I can explain you all through this diagram, just follow the direction of this arrow. Okay, follow the direction of this arrow. So you all can see first we have 1s. After 1s comes 2s. Then 2p. Then 3s. Then 3p. But after 3p, you all can see this is the third column. In third one, we have 3s, 3p, 3d. Yes or no? But while writing the configuration, after 3p, you all are supposed to write 4s. Okay, fine. And then you all are supposed to go back to 3D. So you all can see, after 3P, I go to 4S. Then I write 3D. Then I go to 4P. Now after 4P, you all are supposed to write 5S. You all are understanding, at the beginning is not a problem. Beginning, it is systematic. That is the reason when we wrote for sodium and oxygen, we did not face a problem. Simply write 1S, 2S, 2P, 3S, 3P. Till here, the order is followed, like the numerical order. But after that, it changes a little bit. That is, after 3P, instead of writing 3D, we are supposed to write 4S. So this is because of the difference in energy levels and how the energy level is increasing. Okay, an increasing order of energy level. So you all have to remember this entire thing. Okay, so you can see, students, it starts from 1S. Okay, it goes till 7P. If you all can see the maximum one numerically, but if you all go energy wise, so the least energy is in 1S and the maximum is in 6F. Okay, fine. So you all have to follow this order while writing the configuration. So what does this mean, students? Now see, for example, just remember this much part as if for now. Okay, fine. That is, after 3P, we are supposed to write 4S. Okay, after 3P, we are supposed to write 4S. Then we have to go back to 3D. So now, if I give you all any other compound, for example, for calcium. Can anyone tell me the configuration for calcium? Write it down in your notebook. Try writing it in your notebook. Otherwise, you all will not understand how to do it. Okay? Try writing the configuration. And please answer. Please unmute and answer, students. Don't sit and type. It will take a lot of time. Okay? So calcium has atomic number 20. So how I explain to you all first. Okay, anyone wants to answer, please go ahead. Yes, anyone? See, firstly, the order is same only. Like, first two electrons will go to 1s2. Okay, the next two electrons will go to 2s2. All right, in second shell, we also have P. So in P, students, how many electrons can be accommodated? 6. So till now, I think so, we are done with 10 electrons. Okay, so there are 10 more because we are discussing about calcium. So next, what will come into picture, students? Now you all tell me. After 2P, what will come? Okay, Hitvi has sent the configuration. Okay, correct. Her answer is correct. Okay. All right, students, tell me, after 2P6, now what I am supposed to write?
3S2.
Okay. All right. Tisha has also sent the answer. Okay. We have to write 3S2. All right. Okay. Now tell me, after 3S2, what we are supposed to write?
Three P6.
Okay. Very good. Achha, abhi yahan tak kitne electrons ho gaye? Till here, how many electrons are done? I think so, 18. Yes or no? Yes. So we are still left with 2 electrons, right? Now the important part comes, students. Now you all are supposed to remember that series, okay? And in that series, okay, just a minute. I'll just show you. In this series, after 3P, what comes, students? 3P ke baad 3D aata hai ya 3P ke baad 4S aata hai? 4S aata hai, right? Yes or
4S.
No? Yes. 4S. So here the remaining 2 electrons will go to 4S2. Okay. And this is the configuration for your calcium. So here, instead of, if you all have written 3D2, then it is incorrect. Because according to energy level, after 3P, 4S comes into picture. And after 4S, 3D comes. So agar koi aur higher compound hai, for example, zinc wagera ho gaya. Okay, so then you all have to write accordingly. Students, please let me know if you all are understanding that energy level concept or how to prefer, yes, how to write.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. All right. Now, students, here I want you all to mark certain things. What you all can do is, on this page, okay, on page number 49 only of your textbook, firstly, mark this table, mark this box, star mark it and keep, okay? Next, here, from here till here, okay, this much part, all right, this much part mark and keep, Okay, students, let's read it. Let us read what is written over here. The lower the sum, okay, sum of n plus n for an orbital, the lower is the energy. Alright, if two orbitals have the same n plus l values, then orbital with the lower value of n is of lower energy. This is called n plus l rule. Now, students, sometimes when you all are writing, or ye dekho, ye memorize to karna hi hai. Okay, you all don't have any the option for it. But when you all are writing, if you all are confused, अरे इसके बाद क्या आएगा? इसके बाद 4p था या 5p था? क्या था? समझ नहीं रहा है. So what you all can do is you all can use this n plus l rule. Students, see, we are supposed to go from lower energy level to higher energy level. Please remember that. Okay, fine. Now, where this n plus rule is important, n plus, you all can mark this and you all can put a star mark, because this rule is like a a very beneficial point. If in case you all forget how to write the series, well, you all have to remember it, okay? Because you all are going to write configuration till for a long time, so you all cannot sit and verify using n plus l rule. So you all have to simply memorize it only. But in case confused ho gaye, samajh raha nahi hai, so for the rescue, you all have n plus l rule. Okay. Now, what is n plus l rule? N plus l rule means you all have to do addition of n and l. You all know n is principal quantum number. You all know l is assumed quantum number. Yes or no? Okay, so you all have to do addition of n plus l. Okay, and the lower the sum, the lower is its energy. So if agar kisi ka sum 2 aa raha hai aur kisi ka sum 3 aa raha hai, so out of the two, which is the orbit which has lower energy? Obviously, jiska sum 2 aa raha hai. Common sense. Okay, kam number hai, matlab kam energy. So that will come before. And the higher energy one will come afterwards. Okay, remember, we are going from lower energy to higher level energy. Okay, fine. What if your two orbitals have the same n plus l value? Matlab dono orbitals ka na 3-3 aa raha hai. To tum log kabhi kaise decide? Sum n plus l ka 3 aa raha hai. So how will you all decide? Then what you all are supposed to do is you all have to see kiska n ka value kam hai. Which one has less n value? Okay, fine. This is called n plus n rule. Students, if you are not understanding, they have given a table over here to understand, to make you all understand what they are exactly trying to talk about. So first we have 1s, right? Now we know that, students, for 1s, the value of n is 1 and s ke liye value of l kya hota hai? 0. Yes or no? So 0 plus 1 is what? 1. Okay, fine. Next we have 2s. Now we know that for 2s, n is 2, and because it is s, value of l is 0. So 2 plus 0 is 2. So here it is not a problem. Next we have 2p. Now students, for 2p, obviously n is 2. And when we have p subshell, what is the value of l? 1. So 2 plus 1 is going to give me 3. Okay. Now see, students, here there is a problem. Here, if you all see for 3s, okay, for 3s also, n is 3, l is 0. You all are getting the sum as 3 only. Okay. So for 2p and 3s, according to n plus l rule, the sum is coming 3 only. Now we have to decide which is the lower one. So students, can you all tell me which is the lower energy one out of 2p and 3s and why? Like along with reason, dono mein se lower energy wala kaun sa hai and why? According to keeping in mind n plus l rule. Yes, Tishya, you want to answer?
No, my sign is sticky.
Okay. No, but try to answer, right, students? You all understood the question, right? See, 2p and 3s, in both the scenarios, we are getting sum as 3. Okay, but we have to decide, right, which one is the lower energy one. So how will we decide? It was written over there in the statement that I asked you all to mark.
2p is lower.
Yes, 2p is lower. Why?
Because
n value of n is less.
Yes, very good. Excellent. Okay, fine. Because value of n is less. Alright, fine. So students, students, remember these statements. I'm asking you all to mark these statements because those statements are helpful. Okay. So yeah, they have written, right? You all have to find n plus l, and whoever sum is less means it has lower energy, so it will come first. What if two of them are having the same sum? So when they have the same sum values, okay, Then the orbital with the lower value of n. So in 2p and 3s, obviously which one has lower value of n? 2p, right? So you all can see they have written over here. That is the reason 2p has lower value and 3s is higher. So 3s will come after 2p. Okay, fine. Now what we can do is like we have confusion. See, till 3p it is not a problem. Till 3p it is systematically increasing. Okay, fine. What we can do is just a minute, okay, students. Okay, all right. No, just concentrate on these three values as if for now. Okay, so this is about 3p, 4s, and 3d. Okay, so students, all can see for 3p, the sum we are getting is 4. 3p, okay, for 3p. For 3d, the sum we are getting is 5. So it is very obvious that 3d has higher energy than 3p. Okay. बट इसका मतलब ये है कि हमको उसको लाइन से लिखना है नहीं चेक फॉर 4s एज वेल स्टूडेंट्स आई कैन सी फॉर 4s द एनर्जी वैल्यू इज 4 व्हिच इज लेस देन 3d यस और नो लाइक एज इफ फॉर नाउ आई एम जस्ट कंपेयरिंग 4s एंड 3d लाइक यू ऑल माइट हैव अ क्वेश्चन राइट व्हाई 3d व्हाई 4s इज कमिंग बिफोर 3d बिकॉज 4s हैज एनर्जी वैल्यू लोअर देन दैट ऑफ 3d 4s का एनर्जी 4 आ रहा है और 3d का 5 है सो इट ऑब्वियसली मेक्स विच वन लोअर इफ आई कंपेयर बोथ ऑफ देम 4s लोअर दैट इज द रीजन आफ्टर राइटिंग 3s 3p वी आर सपोज टू राइट 4s देन वी आर सपोज टू राइट 3d ओके फाइन आई होप यू ऑल आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस स्टूडेंट्स ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट इट इज ओके द एनर्जी लेवल्स नाउ देयर आर फ्यू मोर टॉपिक्स दैट आई वांट टू एक्सप्लेन फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर वी आर नॉट डन येट बट आई थिंक सो बाय नाउ यू ऑल वेरी वेल नो हाउ टू राइट कॉन्फिगरेशन इन फैक्ट इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक स्टूडेंट्स यू ऑल कैन सी इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक दे हैव रिटन द कॉन्फिगरेशन फॉर द फर्स्ट 30 एलिमेंट्स ओके एलिमेंट्स यू ऑल कैन फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द पीरियोडिक टेबल दैट इज गिवन सो इट इज नॉट अ बिग क्वेश्चन ओके इट्स नॉट अ बिग प्रॉब्लम हाउ टू ऑब्टेन द एलिमेंट्स What I want you all to do is, okay, students, do not refer this condensed form, okay? Do not refer this condensed form as of for now because I have not yet explained to you all what it is. What I want you all to do before you all attend the next lecture, okay, fine, which is probably going to be next week only mostly, but you all can do it now itself. Like as soon as the lecture gets over, you all can quickly finish this homework. The homework for you all is to write the electronic configuration from hydrogen till zinc. Okay, from hydrogen till zinc. All right, fine. Okay, fine. Please pay careful attention what I'm trying to say. So for the first 30 elements, you all are supposed to write electronic configuration the entire way. Starting from 1s2 till the end, following the energy level. Okay, following the energy level. Remember that. You all have to like after 3s, 3p, you all have to write 4s, then 3d. So you all can refer your textbook obviously because everything is given properly. You all are supposed to write the entire configuration. Okay, fine. So you all understood what you all are supposed to write? What is the homework for you guys?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
See students, the more you all practice, the more good it is for you all because they will ask you all in exam to write electronic configurations. Okay, fine. They'll just give you all random atomic number and they'll ask you all to write the electronic configuration. So the more you all practice, the more you all will understand. Okay, if mistakes are happening, it's fine. You all can refer your textbook, you all can refer your chapter number 4. As if for now, let us not concentrate on this last column because it is the condensed form of configuration. This I'll explain to you all next time. Don't worry about it. Okay, fine. And students, here in this thing, when you all write or normally write the configuration, okay, how I explained to you all, वैसे ही लिखना है पूरा, ठीक है? But you all will see that your answer for, you all can refer this column, in fact, to cross-verify your answer. Plus, but just please don't directly copy it from here because see students I'll tell you all why you all can see in your textbook what they have done in your textbook they have written in one systematic order like pehle 1 ka likha hai fir 2 fir 3 and 4 but energy level wise aise hota hai kya nahi right if you all are supposed to write according to energy level After 3s3p, 4s comes. Then you all are supposed to write 3d. Students, this what you, they have written in your textbook is not wrong. But this leads to a major confusion. Students think that, achha, theek hai, pehle 3s3p, 3d likhna hai, fir 4s. और अकॉर्डिंगली हम लोग फिलअप कर देंगे. वो फिलअप के चक्कर में गलती से इधर उधर फिलअप हो जाता है. तो वैसा करना ही नहीं है. एनर्जी लेवल के अकॉर्डिंग सिस्टमैटिकली लिखना है, जैसे आई एक्सप्लेन टू यू ऑल. दिस यू ऑल कैन वेरीफाई जस्ट टू लाइक सी इफ योर आंसर इज करेक्ट और नॉट. सो इन हियर व्हाट आई वांटेड टू, यस श्रद्धा, यू हैव एनी डाउट? Okay, she raised her hand. So, all right. So, students, here what I was telling you all is there are two answers that won't match. Okay, fine. So, okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. She does not have any doubt. Okay, so two answers that are not going to match. So, the two answers are, students, of chromium and copper. Like when you all write the configuration normally, how I explained to you all. And if you all will cross check from here, you all will see the answer for chromium and copper is not matching. Why that is happening, everything I'll explain next time. Don't worry about it. All I want you all to do is write down all the configurations from hydrogen to zinc, okay? Properly, everything from 1s2, 2s2, following the energy level. Okay, fine. Following this diagram that is there. Okay, fine. So obviously for higher compounds, you all will have higher configuration, students. So you all will enter into 4s, 4p and all. Okay, fine. So you all can see after 3d, you all are supposed to write 4p. After 4p, you all are supposed to write 5s and so on. Just follow this zigzag arrow. Okay, or they have written linearly over here. So I can refer this as well. Okay, fine.